Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Today I will be talking about the World Food Prize and how to stop world hunger. Norman Borlaug once said, "Food is the moral right of all who are born into this world." Norman Borlaug was the founder of the World Food Prize organization that is going on today. It has moved down into the capital of Iowa, Des Moines. Just last week, I got to attend the World Food Prize entire organization, a part of the Global Youth Institute. Now this, I'll explain later about how I got accepted into this, but basically the World Food Prize is trying to end hunger. That's the main point of the whole organization. But the main part is, how can we, the people, help? How can we help stop world hunger? Not just those people that are winning the awards. How can we help, just within our local community? Norman Borlaug, as I said, was the founder of the World Food Prize, and he is known as the man who saved a billion lives. He worked with wild rice in the work of genetics of how to improve the yield per acre, how to get it to work into different vegetation areas in Africa, China, wherever. But you cannot forget about just the local area that he helped, here in Iowa. Not just clear in Africa or clear in China, just here local in the United States. And it is started with 6 countries, and now it is to basically the entire continent of Africa, over half of Asia and Europe, and the entire North America and parts of South America. Sir Fazlan Hasbin Abed is from Bangladesh, and he was the 2015 World Food Prize winner, and he is also known as the biggest laureate of the year. And what he accepted was basically the Nobel Peace Prize of Agriculture. That's what the World Food Prize is. He used all of his extra money that he has made throughout being the president and other jobs in Bangladesh to go and improve empowering women and improving the voice of the hungry. He went and started a program called BRAC. It is a nonprofit organization just like the World Food Prize. He did everything in his power to help feed the hungry, to help send food home with the kids at school, to help with the hungry, malnourished women that can't work because their husbands won't let them, because the women don't get a voice. In most of these nonprofit organizations, they empower the women. Now, Joyce Badon is the former president of Malawi, and she is the second so-called runner-up of the World Food Prize with the Field of Excellence Award. She has done the same thing. She has gone back to her home country and helped empower the little girls at the school. And that is her biggest focus, is ending hunger. That's what all these people want to do, is end hunger. Now, I got accepted into the Global Youth Institute through the Iowa State Youth Institute. Each of us in this picture here that you can kind of see have wrote a research paper on one of these topics. And we, there was 4 Iowans, and we all went through the Iowa State. We gave the same process, did a speech on our paper. And then we, for 4 hours, basically, you get time to go through all 8 papers, but the main part was coming up with solutions to end hunger. That's what our passion is. That's what all these people in agriculture want. They want to end hunger. It's our passion. We don't want anyone to go to bed hungry. Now, we got to take part in a food supper, is what it's called, basically, and if you got this color card, you didn't get any food. You got a bowl of rice to share with everyone on the floor. We basically got to experience what people go through on a daily basis in Africa, China, and just here locally in the United States. And a part of my group, we had people from New York, Ohio, Texas, Nebraska, Iowa, and China. Now, the one on the far right, he was from China, and he had to have an interpreter, because basically when you come here, it's all English. So it's hard, but just his ideas from China versus us here in Iowa or just in the United States, completely different, but for the same purpose, to end world hunger. You can earn an internship through a 2-month straight that you'd work one-on-one with a scientist in a foreign country. Like, I have the option of going to Malawi, but I have not made my decision on that yet. But in 1.5 hours, we packaged over 24,000 meals to send to Africa. Or to send half of them, we're going to the local food banks here in Des Moines, Iowa. Now, that's something that you can do at your school. through the FFA, through just your entire school. Package meals. Send them to your people. You can also, basically what we have come up with is make a small building where people can come and have a community garden, where they can go to school and feel safe, where the kids and parents can come and learn the new agriculture opportunities and technologies being implemented here in the United States is what we are looked upon for the agricultural power. And then 1.3 billion tons of food were wasted on an average yearly basis. 1.3 billion tons of food. All that food could have been going to the people that are hungry in Africa, in China, in the United States, in Iowa, in New York, in your own county of Tama County. You could give your food to your local banks, to your local counties. Take your extra food. Don't waste it. Don't just throw it in the garbage for the coons to find. Feed the people. That's what we're here to do. Feed the people. According to the National Environmental Program, 1.3 billion tons of food are wasted. Way too much. So Sir Fazlan Haslin Abed from Bangladesh has used his money to help the hungry and empower women. How are you going to help? Do your part, do your share, whether that's packaging meals or assisting in implementing new technologies, or just get involved with the World Food Prize. Help the fight to end hunger. Thank you for coming. This concludes my presentation.